So I was going to get back up and look around for him just because I was concerned. As I got up, I started hearing these ticking or clicking sounds, kind of like a rodent. And I looked around the dark room, and only then did I notice Jason standing in the corner of my room, arms flat at his sides. I let out a scream and jumped, startled, as putting how I felt mildly. Yes.
Continue our saga with Mr. Nightmare, and it's talking about three crazy best friend stories. I guess they're not best friends, they happen to be crazy best friends. So let's go ahead and get it started. Go ahead, okay. Let's get it started. Yeah. Ha! Did I see that last time on video? Let's go ahead and get it started. I'm trying not to be too loud, it's like 4 o'clock in the morning here. In Indiana.
This is a very delicate personal story of mine, so I'm gonna change names and small details around so nobody may recognize it to be me. I'd been good friends with a girl named Jess for almost 6 years, since high school basically. We even went to college together and dormed together. When we were in our junior year of college, we moved out of the dorms and into an off-campus apartment. It was a three-bedroom apartment, and our third roommate was our friend Stacy. We were less close with Stacy, but we had no problems with her. In fact, the three of us would go out together on the weekends. I just had more of that best friend tell everything vibe with Jess, if you know what I mean. It was the spring semester, spring break was approaching, and we were planning the days we'd be going home. Stacy and I were planning on leaving the same day. Jess was going to be staying an extra day because she said she needed to work one final shift at her job. So the day came that Stacy and I left. I said bye to Jess, even though I would probably be seeing her the next day at home. I left and hit the road. But you ever forget something, and when you remember it, it hits you like a brick?
Yes.
That was what happened to me while on the freeway. I pulled to the side of the road in a hurry and checked my bags for my laptop. I checked my backpack too. I realized I had forgotten it. I had driven half an hour already, and now I had to go back just to get my laptop. As much as I didn't want to, I had to. I couldn't go almost 2 weeks without my computer.
Yeah.
So my half-hour drive back to the apartment began.
30 minutes.
When I got back, I let myself in and called for Jess, ready to tell her what an idiot I was. She didn't call back, so she didn't appear to be in the apartment. Her door was wide open, though. She usually kept it shut, especially when she wasn't home. I checked my room for my laptop up and down, but I couldn't find it. Curiously, I walked to Jess's doorway and looked into her room, and there it was. My laptop was open on her bed, next to her laptop. Why didn't she call or text me? I went to pick it up and saw my laptop was signed in. She somehow got into my account, then she knew my password. I switched to looking at her laptop, and it got worse from here. There was a folder open, containing a bunch of pictures. Pictures of me. Some of the most disturbing pictures I found were pictures of me passed out on the couch after drunk nights out, and pictures of me in a towel, either in my room or in the bathroom. My heart was racing. I shut my laptop and started searching her room, her closet specifically, and I found a number of my belongings, mostly articles of clothing, some I won't mention because it's disturbing and embarrassing. I grabbed all my stuff I could find and stormed out. I locked my bedroom door and left the apartment. I didn't call Jess. I called my parents as soon as I got back in my car. They didn't have any words. They couldn't even give me advice because this was so messed up. By the time I got home, I saw Jess blocked me on everything. Instagram, Snap. I assume she blocked my number too, but I never tried contacting her again. By the time I got back to the apartment a week and a half later, all of her stuff was out of the apartment. I didn't see her again for almost a whole year, until she was out with our mutual friends and we ran into each other. She wouldn't even look at me. She couldn't even gather the courage to confront me about it. person that I thought was my best friend for 6 years was a sick, twisted stalker storing lewd pictures of me and stealing my belongings. This brought to light an incident that happened our first month in the apartment. I was drunk after a night of drinking, and I woke up shortly after falling asleep to a sound in my closet. I remembered sitting up, rubbing my eyes, and looking around the room, thinking I saw and heard someone in the closet. I was so scared that I ran to Stacy's room screaming because her room was closer. By the time she went to check the room with me, the closet was empty, and Jess allegedly never woke up to come check the commotion. It made sense to me now that she was in my closet that night. I get sick to my stomach thinking about all the things that she may have done that I will never know about.
Oh my God. You don't know. Oh.
My old best friend Jason had a number of disorders. Well, I guess if you'd call them that. He had insomnia, he frequently had night terrors, and he battles depression. I'm sure he's got other personal issues that he doesn't really share. All I know is he takes a lot of medication. One day, he and his roommate were having serious issues, worse than usual. Jason called me all distressed, saying they just got into a screaming match with one another, and it almost got physical, and that he needed a place to crash for a couple nights. I told him not a problem. He could sleep on the couch in my apartment for a few nights. When he arrived, I tried pressing him for more details on the fight, like why it happened, but he didn't tell me anything. I respected that though. If he didn't want to share personal details like that, I wasn't going to press him further for it. He dropped his backpack full of clothes in the corner of the living room, and he kind of just watched TV and played Call of Duty on my Xbox for most of the day and night. I hung out with him for a bit, but I had my own things to take care of. When I got home, Jason was passed out on the couch under a blanket. I passed him quietly and got ready for bed. I woke up randomly, feeling extremely thirsty, and the water bottle I kept next to my bed was empty. So I quietly went through the living room towards the kitchen. As I passed by the couch, I couldn't help but notice Jason wasn't on it. His bag was still in the corner of the room, though, so it's not like he left. Maybe he ran to the bathroom. Either way, I didn't look around for him. I went back to my room and kept the door open a crack. It was a long time that I didn't hear Jason leaving the bathroom, though, or simply laying back down on the couch for that matter. So I was going to get back up and look around for him just because I was concerned. But as I got up, I started hearing these ticking or clicking sounds, kind of like a rodent. I looked around the dark room, and only then did I notice Jason standing in the corner of my room, arms flat at his sides. I let out a scream and jumped, startled, as putting how I felt mildly. Yes, even in this dark room, I was able to realize it was Jason. I threw my pillow at him and yelled, "What the actual hell are you doing?" He flinched and he stopped making the ticking noises, then walked out of my room in this stiff, creepy manner. I heard him basically collapse onto the couch. I stepped out into the living room to try to talk to him. He didn't answer. I realized he must have been sleepwalking. The next morning, I asked him about
fuck that.
It. He said he didn't remember any of it. I asked him if he tends to sleepwalk. He said no, or at least not that he was aware of. But other than that, the day was pretty normal. We chatted and hung out in the living room for a while. Then I had to go out and run some errands. He'd be staying one more night at my place. I once again woke up randomly in the middle of the night. This time I wasn't thirsty, so I don't know what woke me up. But for curiosity's sake, I got up to check if Jason was on the couch. He wasn't. Not again. I called Jason's name pretty loud. He wasn't in the bathroom or the kitchen, nor did he seem to be in my room. I climbed back into bed and tried texting his phone, but nothing delivered, so it seemed to be off. I called his name one more time, really loud, and then I heard this disturbing, muffled speaking sound. I looked at the closet where it was coming from, and I saw through the 6-inch opening, Jason's face in the dark, peeking through the door, his hands over his mouth. I yelled at him full volume to get him out of my closet. He didn't listen. He had to be sleepwalking again. I went to the closet to open it fully. I grabbed his arm and pulled it to get him out of the closet. But as I did that, I saw the big carving knife in his hand. I looked at his half-lifeless looking face and ran to the bathroom and locked myself in. I considered calling the police, but I didn't. I waited until I heard him go back to the couch. Then I ran to my...
Jason would have got his ass beat. I don't care if he was... he was sleepwalking or what. Get out of here.
...room and locked the door. I didn't... didn't understand how sleepwalking could escalate to a level that he'd be picking up weapons.
Listen, sleepwalking is very serious. Like, I used to sleepwalk when I was younger. And, like, when one night that my house, I grew up in, is not easy to navigate. It's not a long hallway. Like, you gotta make some turns in that house. My room was at the very end of the hallway. So one night I got up and I literally I don't know if I knew where I was going, but like one night I had got up apparently and walked out of my room, opened the door, walked out, went down to the step. Like sometimes my mom would catch me like just sitting on the step sometimes. Like one time she called me and then she called me in the room and apparently I walked in. She said that I had started saying like, I'm looking for a machine. And well, she said, what machine are you looking for? I was like, I don't know. I'm looking for a machine. Well, I don't know what I said, but like literally like that's very possible. Like you can pick up things and you can know where you're going, even when you sleep. That's crazy. Like sleepwalking is very serious.
Laying in my bed at 3 in the morning, I DM'd his roommate telling him what just happened and asking him what happened between the two of them. He didn't reply until the next morning. I woke up to 3 long DMs from his roommate. Basically, in short, he told me Jason is a sicko freak who needs help. And he said Jason came into his room with a knife the last night he was there and was standing at the foot of his bed before he tackled him to the floor. He said Jason claimed it was sleepwalking, but his roommate didn't believe it. This made the whole thing even scarier because Jason told me that he doesn't sleepwalk, or not that he's aware of. I asked Jason to leave that day because of what was going on. He did so. I think he went back to his mom's house. Jason and I still follow each other on social media, but I kind of faded things out from him after that. I still don't know what to make of him or the fact that he brought a knife into more than one person's room in the middle of the night. This is a deeply personal and disturbing story. I'm not sure why I'm choosing to share it with the internet, but here goes. I don't have too many friends. Up until a few days ago, I looked at this guy Milo as my best friend for a while. I met him in one of my college classes. We got along mostly because we always cheated on tests together and helped each other to find the answers for our homework assignments. Eventually, we started hanging out outside of class, and I would sooner or later start telling him a lot of personal stuff that I didn't tell many other people. Just because I felt most comfortable with him didn't mean I saw him as this super high-quality, genuine guy. He was just someone I thought was somewhat there for me. There was this one night I didn't have plans, so I hit him up, and he suggested we hit one of the bars in town. I drove the two of us there since I wasn't planning on getting too drunk. This night, though, he for whatever reason decided to get blackout wasted, ordering shot after shot, mixed drink after mixed drink. I had a couple drinks and cut myself off so I could drive. Milo was so drunk that he was approaching random girls and saying some pretty foolish things that were causing me to cringe. At one point, I had to apologize to these two girls for him and tried to make light of it. But really, the night just wasn't going the way I wanted it to, which was to have a chill, laid-back night out with my friend. He made it stressful, so I pulled him out of the bar and sat him in my car to drive us back to his apartment. I'd never actually been inside of his apartment before. This was the first time. I walked him inside and laid him down on his couch, where he instantly seemed to just crash and pass out. He dropped his phone out of his hand and onto the floor, but didn't flinch. So yeah, he was out. His phone was on and unlocked, though. Honestly, I always wondered what the hell Milo even did for work, considering he always seemed to be down to spend money, but never talked about work. In a perfect world, I shouldn't have done this, but I picked up his phone and started going through his camera roll. I don't know what I was expecting to find, honestly. I was really just being a sneaky snoop, but I was doing it because I often thought Milo was a little sketchy and was hiding some things. His camera roll was full of junk, like screenshots of websites, texts, and a bunch of selfies. So I went to the album section and found this suspicious album titled Girls. I opened it expecting to find nudes or porn pictures or whatever, but no, it was much worse. What I found in there were pictures of young women tied up to a bed, and a lot of the pictures the women were visibly distressed and crying. I won't get into any graphic detail, but the pictures were disturbing. I thought maybe they were from the internet at first, but I took note of the blue bed cover. I went to Milo's room and flicked on the light. When I saw the blue bed cover, I shook my head in disgust, and I guess because I actually had no idea how to feel. I sent a couple of the pictures to myself, then deleted the texts off his phone. I put the phone back on the floor next to him and left. The next day he texted me, "I know you went in my room. We need to talk now." He followed that up with, "If you saw any pictures, they were just role-playing pictures."
Hell no, I don't believe none of that shit.
I don't know how he knew I saw the pictures though, and I don't know how he knew I was in his room. That next night he came to my door and rang the bell like 30 times. I ignored it. And hours later, when I was trying to sleep, rocks were thrown at my window, and I heard Milo outside calling up to me. Moments later, I heard him trying to open one of my windows. That's when I picked up my phone and called him, and yelled at him to simply leave me alone or I would be calling the cops. Then I hung up. He didn't text me or call me again. I still have those two pictures on my phone, and I'm really wondering what I should do and how I should proceed with it. If he really knows I saw those pictures, I don't know if he's gonna target me if he gets the chance, or if he's gonna move out or what, but at this very moment, I'm a little scared for my well-being.
Crazy best friends. You never know who you're with. You never know. Luckily, I don't have any.
John Henry with his hammer makes a little.
I may have some crazy best friends, but I don't know about it. Who knows? Do you have some crazy best friends? Because I'm trying to figure out. I don't want to meet. If I have some crazy best friends, I don't want to see them. Well, I don't know. I don't know. It's a hard thing to talk about because I haven't experienced none of that type of stuff. But I have experienced sleepwalking, but it's not like what the guy was saying in this video. I was actually sleepwalking before and not knowing it. So what happens when you sleepwalk? Like, what is like a spirit take control of your body, or is this like some type of something? Let me know in the comments. I want to know. I want to thank you all for tuning in. It's your boy, AKJ. Make sure you like and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.